So today's video comes from the couch where I'm sick, or I'm starting to get sick, or I'm maybe hopefully getting over being sick. You can tell that I'm sick because I have a blanket wrapped around my body, so I have a really good prop. And I've got a nice cup of tea. It's lukewarm. Two thoughts I've had about this while being sick on the couch. One is that when you start your own business, you don't get sick days. You also don't get to go into the office and be like, I'm sick. So, you know, and you get a lot of sympathy and nobody really expects that much from you. And you can always send an email saying something like, sorry, I've just been a little bit under the weather, but if I could just have till tomorrow. And, you know, someone always writes back, sure thing, feel better, smiley face. Well, I'm not really, that's not happening here. So that's the one thing. And I guess everybody kind of tells you that is when you start your own business or you are your own boss, that you don't get sick days and you still have to work. The other thing is I made a video earlier this week and I was talking about how I was feeling really stressed and I was feeling a lot of anxiety. And I had talked about that stress does make you sick. And I find that to be a real motivator. Oh, hi, sweetheart. Hi. How are you? Do you want to be in a video? You are. You already are. And I find that to be a real motivator towards managing my stress and managing my anxiety is this effect that it really has on your health. And it's in a way, it's really interesting. I don't like being sick, but it's really interesting to feel the ways in which my mental emotional state do affect me physically. And it's something I talked about in my video about anxiety techniques is using a physical technique to mitigate a mental emotional state. It's kind of the reverse is this, you know, mental emotional state that I was in has had a physical effect on me. And I've had to just accept that. The other thing I've had to do is not beat myself up about it because that's only going to make it worse, right? Like I'm sick. And so what I need is to take care of myself. And what I need is to nurture myself and love myself and care for myself and get myself back into fighting shape. And the way to do that is not to judge myself for getting stressed out in the first place and getting myself sick. It's an interesting reminder in life. It shouldn't have to get to this point that you get so stressed out that you're sick. But I think it's important to know that that can happen. And I think, as I said, it's really motivating to manage your stress and to find ways to calm down and find ways to center yourself and find ways to get more balance and rest and peace and play in your life, because this is what can happen. It's kind of like, you know what it reminds me of? It's like the whole idea of staying hydrated. And people think, oh, when I'm thirsty, I'll drink water. But the reality is, like, once you're thirsty, you're already dehydrated. And so that's why it's important to sort of maintain, getting, they say, 8 glasses a day. I think that's, I think 8 glasses a day is great. I don't measure them. I don't count them. I just keep a really big water bottle with me throughout the day, and I just keep refilling it, and I keep drinking it. And I feel pretty confident that I'm getting to at least 8, if not more, glasses. But at the point is that I'm always thinking about hydration. I'm always thinking about how important it is to stay hydrated. Hi, Lola. Do you want to be in this video again? So this is Lola. This is my, she's got a little collar on because she's had some surgery on her intimate areas. And so she is about 1.5 weeks out of surgery and needs to keep that little life preserver on so she doesn't chew at her stitches. So anyway, really the point of this video today or the message of this video, usually like to have a piece of advice or some sort of tool or something for you. But this is probably more of just a glimpse into like what's going on in my life and what I'm learning as I go through this process of really starting a new life and realizing little things like this that I really like. It's like really something that I've become very clear on this week is that I do need to prioritize my self-care and I do need to prioritize my self-love and I do need to take care of myself and I need to have actual tools and time set in my day to focus on that. It's so easy when you're starting your own business or you're focused on some sort of, you know, I need to be able to like make my point without you making all this noise. I mean, she's great, but it's just like, dude. But I think it's important to remember that. You know, I think we often think that we have to just keep our nose to the grindstone until we pass out in order to be successful and get things done. I think it's important that when we are, you know, if you are in that space, if you are, I'm gonna fix myself, I look like a, you know, not one of those videos, you know. I think it's important to remember that you do need to take care of yourself, and that it's not about just working as long as you can. I don't understand. Here comes the dog. It's like she knows I'm filming. And I guess, I mean, maybe I should just hang out with the dog, and rest. Just rest and relax, right? I'm just gonna rest and relax. So yeah, this would be, if you're gonna have any takeaway from this video, it's take care of yourself. And make time for rest and make time for play. And don't think that being successful just means working as hard as you can until you collapse, and then, you know, hopefully some success comes out of that, because that's, even if you are successful, that's a terrible way to get there. And it's not sustainable. She's laid down. So now that I'm done, she's relaxed. Anyway, take care of yourselves. I'm going to take care of myself. I'm probably going to microwave this tea because, it's not even warm anymore. Yeah. What a difference, heat makes. Anyway, have a great day.